Hey there guys, welcome to another video. My name is Sparckman, I'm a game developer. Today we are going to create a text adventure or a text adventure game boss. Let me show you the demo. Here is the demo, and in this game you are E. Oh no, they got me already, son of a gun. Not this time, Z. Oh, he got me again. Right. Try the down approach. Down, down, up. That's good, that was good. No! As you can see, Z means business. Oh no! It's actually very hard to beat. Oh no, 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 no. One more time. See if I can beat Z. No! Okay, one more time. Down, down. No, he got me again. All right, so let's open the example file, which you are going to find under the description below. We interrupt this broadcast to let you know about a contest. Yes, we're going to have a game making contest. And according to Jeff from Clickteam, there could be even prizes, which is good. Everyone likes prizes. So we're going to try to do this every month. Okay, so I say we, as in the whole channel. Some people think I actually work for Clickteam, but I don't. So the Sparckman challenge could be a monthly thing. This could be a monthly contest where everyone can participate. The winners are going to be decided by vote. So the deadline for each contest is going to be the end of the month. I just wanted to let you know in advance, so maybe you can start getting something ready. Let me know if you have any suggestions for the contest. Leave a comment down below. The Sparckman challenge could be a monthly thing, depending how this goes. Okay, so now back to the tutorial. Okay, so if you don't know what software I'm using for making games, there is a link down below where you can download the free version. There is also a link to the paid version, which allows you to create commercial games. Okay, so let's go over the assets. Here's the Z, which is just a letter. Here's his hit animation. You can see that I'm using these objects for the ground. Here's my main character, which is just a letter. Here's the equal sign, which is really a picture. Health bar, that's an energy. And I'm using the physics engine. Now this whole thing, it's about 11 events. Doesn't feel like it, but it is. This is the background. It's just a picture. Okay, so if you run this frame, you'll notice that nothing happens except for the E falls down. Let's go to the event editor and let's create our first collisions. See if I can complete this in 2 minutes. The E collides with the ground, which is this A, and E stops. Try it out. That works fine. This is already a platform object, so notice that we have a counter here. So this is only going to work if this counter is at 2-0. And our jumping animation is not playing. Negated. That works fine. If the user presses down, we're gonna set that counter to 1. Press down. And we fall. Object I'm using, this one is B. If we collide with B, then he stops. And we're gonna set the counter back to 0. Press down. Down. And that works fine. If the user presses control, then we can create an object. An equal sign in front of the E. We can play a sound at the same time. Let's do the scrolling. Always center window position relative to the E. Our scrolling. Now the Z moves because it is a path object. Okay, this is the path it follows. So if the equal sign collides with the Z, then we change the animation sequence of the Z to hit. But we're gonna make sure that the animation is not playing already. Hit is not playing, negated. And we're gonna destroy the equal sign. So when the animation hit is finished, we're gonna change this animation sequence back to stop. try it out. Let's make the Z shoot back at us. We're gonna do it based on distance compared to two general values. Z position, distance with a point. For the X, we're gonna use the X position of the E. And for the Y, we're gonna use the Y position of E. The distance needs to be lower than 400 pixels. We're gonna use the timer. Every use calculation, random range, 100 milliseconds to 1200. We're going to fire an O from this position relative to the Z. We need to make the O look in direction of the player or the E. Whoa, you got me twice already. The O collides with the E, then we destroy E and maybe the O as well. So if the number of E's is equal to zero, then we can restart the frame. Whenever we hit the Z, we want to decrease his counter. Subtract one from counter. No! Okay, I have to approach this a little different. Okay, I'm gonna come down from the bottom. No! If you like this video, hit the like button. And if you didn't like the video, smack the dislike button. And now it's time for the first and top comment. And today's top comment is Miles the Creator. Again. The end of the stupid and the first comment is Tree Friend Augustus. Okay, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter. My Twitter account is SparckmanX. And I will see you in the next episode. Bye now.